It's the extra poo that makes all the difference.
You know, people say they're into roguelikes, but then they complain about how such and such a game screwed them with RNG. This never tracked for me, you know? Kinda comes across to my ears like, yeah, I'm totally into pasta, but I'm not big on noodles. The randomness is the thing. It's the base on which everything is built. But maybe I'm being unfair. After all, roguelikes are the big hot thing precisely because you can build all sorts of gameplay on top of that bed of RNG. It's the sauce that goes on the pasta. I guess you can like the sauce, but be annoyed that there's all this noodly stuff crowding up the bowl. This is something I was thinking about while playing Sol Cesto. See, the developers, and they're French, so forgive me in advance while my clumsy American tongue nat-1s its dexterity roll while I'm trying to pronounce these, but, Tambouli, Gerard Zucchini, and Shario Spirale. I think that's right, I don't. Those are the devs. Anyway, those fine folks saw I had some nice things to say about the Sol Cesto demo and were kind enough to offer me a review copy. Thank you. And I'm going to give the old disclosure at the top here, mostly for ethics reasons, but also because I want to be as cool as Casey Explosion when I grow up. Anyways, playing this game reminded me of that thing where people say they like roguelikes, but they don't like getting jerked around by random numbers. What they're talking about there is what I like to call probability play, and what I like to explain is the reason gambling is addictive. See, RNG in roguelikes isn't just about shuffling power-ups and level bits around, it's about crunching numbers and mitigating your odds. Doing all these little bits of on-the-fly calculation, knowing that success isn't assured. And I confess, it's not for everyone, but it's very much a me thing. Like, I will seriously enjoy losing 10 games of Balatro in a row. But I also get how that can be disappointing for people more used to having some more direct control over their own success. But on the off chance that you don't overthink things the way I do, then good news, now there's Sol Cesto. And if you're asking the question, do I even like probability play? And Sol Cesto's gonna answer that for you. It's a great entry level into that discussion. The premise is, okay, I'll be honest, I don't think this thing has any story more ambitious than an excuse plot. Apparently the sun is gone, you're looking for it underground because the last time Galileo tried to tell people where the sun actually lives, he got a life sentence, and that's the reason why you're in a dungeon full of gross monsters. The core gameplay is based around a 4x4 grid of monsters, traps, treasure, and strawberries. Your main task is to pick one of the rows, know when you fellas gonna land randomly on one of those spaces. You could get some treasure, you could end up fighting a monster, any of you. Every level has a minimum number of moves you have to make before you can press on. So the challenge is in calculating your odds, as well as using your items and abilities to pull the RNG into your favor. Now, the reason I call this entry-level probability play is because of the base math you're working with. Balatro's great, but you're starting with a 1 in 52 chance of getting any given card, a 1 in 13 chance of a specific rank, a 1 in 4 chance of a suit, all of that's getting adjusted as more cards are drawn, and that's before you start adding and removing cards and yada yada yada, you see where I'm getting at. Sol Cesto makes the whole calculation more simple. Base 1 in 4, adjusted from there, bam. It's a much lower barrier to entry, one that's made more accessible because the game even does that math for you. As your items and abilities accumulate, the percent chance of being attracted to or repulsed by certain space fillers starts to become crunchier. But good news, you don't have to do any crunching yourself. Just hold your mouse over the row and hey, look at that, all the percent chances show up, along with a little thought balloon telling you what will happen when you land on the spot. I like this because it centers the gameplay around making well-informed decisions. It's having all the cards flipped and not feeling railroaded by an invisible hand. Part of me wonders just a little bit if what the RNG haters really hate is having to make ballpark shots in the dark based on knowing what's in the deck but not how it's stacked. Sol Cesto shifts that paradigm around, giving the player way more visibility and agency, but still never guaranteeing success. And that is the core of probability gameplay. There's a lot that can be said about the grimsical art style and wonderful sound design, but I'm pretty sure I already said most of those in my Steamfest video. Go watch that one again, I could use the views. Also, like and subscribe, pretty please, I could probably be saying that more often. But I think I want the takeaway here to be, if games like Blueprints, Balatro, and Binding of Isaac bothered your brain with the belief that blind barriers are best for gameplay, then check out the free demo for Sol Cesto and examine those feelings. Hey, it might confirm your suspicions about just not liking RNG, it might narrow your focus into the aspects of RNG you're not a fan of, it might even bring your opinion around to liking probability play. I guess you're just gonna have to take that chance. Hooray for humanity!
math. It won't do you a bit of good to review math. It's so simple, so very simple, that only a child